Hello everybody, and welcome back to the range. Tom here, and today on At the Range, we are doing a 1940 Woody's. I've always liked these kind of cars. I thought they looked neat, you know. I really wanted to see about doing something specific to this thing. So why don't we head down to the range, and let's get started. It was Johnny Lightning, I think it was. I can't remember, but it already had a screw in it, so it didn't take long to take it apart. You know, the hardest part was trying to get stuff out without breaking it, and i.e. the dashboard. You know, the dashboard, I had to drill some posts out and, you know, pry it loose. But it came out. I was able to get it back together, no problem. And I love what I did with this thing. The colors came together. Everything worked out. You know, I wanted to do something, you know, cool but different. But, you know, you'll see what I'm talking about here in a, later on in the video. But, you know, I got the AMX Rebel coming up soon. But I still got like a week before it's due, and it ain't even going to take me that long to knock it out, because I've already got it planned out. I've already pre-drilled the post out and tapped the holes, so it's set up and it's ready to go for that. You know, I'm thinking about doing one other video just to get it going. Just to have like something else to do. I'm looking around my shop, looking around the range, just seeing what all I can do. You know, I'm going to be mailing off the giveaway builds at the beginning of the month, and I got a couple trades that I'm doing recently, because I don't know what it is, but I've been on a movie car kick for a little while now. You know, I want to try to get some movie cars built. I found a 32 Ford coupe that, you know, that I'm wanting, and it's on the way. Well, it will be. But I got a couple other cars that I'm going to be doing. They're on the way soon. And, you know, I'm trying to build like collections up. You know, I got like race cars, you know, my NASCAR setups. And not counting the four horse in one. You know, I got 5-6 movie car builds already done. So I'm going to be putting them together as a set. I'm going to be doing all the Bumblebee vehicles. I'm going to be doing three of the American Graffiti cars. And yeah, we'll just have to see what happens. So what I ended up doing with this 40 Willys is I cut the back half of it from the front doors all the way back. I cut that off of it. You know, started with my jeweler saw, then worked my way over to my Dremel tool. You know, it took a while to cut out, so, you know, I kind of knocked out some of the video footage. But, you know, took my Dremel, I cut it, I sanded some of it down, then I took my file to it afterwards. You know, to smooth it out, make it look like it was pretty much straight up. And, you know, you can see that I'm working on making it a pickup truck. You know, Woody's. And honestly, I love how it turned out, you know. I had to do some grinding out of the wheel wells to make the tires that I chose fit. And the tires that you're going to be seeing here in a few are not the same tires that I chose to go with this casting, because what I originally was planning on was making it like a motorcycle hauler. And I'm not talking about for the scaled motorcycles, the Hot Wheels motorcycles. Those are just way too big. I actually had a 1/64 scale printed motorcycles I got from Benchwork Toys a while back, and I mean a while back. And I was gonna make it to where the back hatch dropped down, you know, it could haul a motorcycle, but it didn't turn out that way. So, what I did was, I actually, like I always do, I winged it. I, you know, ended up just not worrying about putting like a tailgate style ramp on it. And ended up going a different route with this thing. Because I couldn't figure out how I was going to do the tailgate. I knew and I had an idea of what I could do. But I didn't end up doing that. So, yeah, it didn't quite go the way I was wanting. But I'm kind of glad I went another direction with it. And you know, I got my styrene here. And what I'm doing is I'm just going to be blocking off the back half of it. You know, I cut it down to size to where it'll fit. And, you know, I had a back. It don't have no back glass. It's just a straight up, you know, solid piece. I sanded down. And, you know, got it to where it would fit and glued it in. And, you know, the kind of the usual stuff that, you know, I would do. You know, I made it fit. Even though I had to actually, it wouldn't fit really good with the part of the interior that I had cut out on it. Because I had to make sure that it fit with the interior. Well, I didn't really cut the interior, now that I think about it. I only removed the back seat of the interior portion of it. And it fit in there. It actually did exactly what I was wanting it to do. I had to modify the back end to fit the wheels that I put on there. And it wouldn't fit in the normal style case. I noticed that. So I had to use an M2 case to put it in. And I'm glad I did. It looks really, really good. And, I was very fond of this casting. You know, my dad gave it to me. You know, he said, do what you can with this. And we'll go from there. But, you know, I'm going to be doing a restoration sometime in the future. I don't know when. I got a car, it's a 69 AMX dragster called the Dragon Lady. And I had to look it up, and sure enough, it was actually a real dragster. I didn't think it was. So, I'm on the lookout for decals, you know, trying to find somebody to make me some decals for this one, because I'm going to strip it completely down, I'm going to put new tires on it, I'm going to put brand new paint job like it was supposed to be, because the one I got purplish color, and honestly, that's not the actual original color of the car, because I did some research and it was actually red, white, and blue. So I'm gonna try to do what I can and get that car to where it looks like the actual car that, you know, the lady drove. Shirley something, I can't remember her, can't remember what it says for the last name or anything like that. So, you know, I put it out on Instagram about it. You know, I talked to my Paul over at Diecast Graveyard about it. You know, I really want to do this for my dad because he likes the car. It's one he don't have, and I want to restore it to what the actual car looked like. And not some knockoff Johnny Lightning that it is. And that's what it is. It's a Johnny Lightning. And yeah, I really want to do something with it. I want my, you know, my dad's a big car guy like I am. Excuse me. And, you know, I just want to go from there and see what I can do. But, you know, I extended the cab of the Woody's a little bit so I can fit the interior in with this back that I made for it out of styrene. And it turned out really good. I had to do a lot of sanding though. You know, I cut out a lot of sanding video footage because I know it would have just got boring watching somebody sand something the entire time. So I cut it out. You know, I cut out a lot of the footage, tried to drop it down, you know. I went from about 2.5 hours down to 19.5 minutes. So I can't complain too much. And, you know, here I am mixing the Milliput up. You know, I'm getting it ready to put around the edges and fill in the gaps and stuff of the back that I put in. So, you know, I'm really trying to work on that and trying to do better. On, you know, just do better on my projects. You know, I got a 3 million mice build coming up. It's I think it's a truck into the wasteland or something. Something to do with a truck going into the wasteland. I need to get some more information done on that. But it's not due until April 19th, so I'm probably gonna participate in that. You know, try to get, you know, my work out there to other channels. You know, the ones that I don't really talk to, but. Turns out the 3 Blind Mice, you know, and I'm throwing their name out there because I found out they subscribed to my channel, and I appreciate that, you know, and trust me, I'm willing to do some upcoming builds if you guys, you know, would be alright with me doing it. And, you know, I want to get my progress going out there to other channels so, you know, people can see what I can do. You know, I've seen what other people can do, and I'm amazed. And a lot of the time, they're the ones that give me the ideas. And I'm not saying I steal their ideas. I just kind of incorporate my own little way into what they do. You know, I'm going to be getting some police decals later on because I got this old sedan. I'm going to be making an old school, like, Bonnie and Clyde style cop car. You know, I don't know what year car they had, or I'd make it into a Bonnie and Clyde car. But that's not that big of a deal. You know, I really want to work on doing certain things. And I ended up deciding, you know, I'm going to make some, like, roll bars for this thing. You know, I took some of my little rolled up wire that I got, folded it in half, put part of it onto a Dremel bit that I used, and I just took the other end and put it in my drill and just started twisting, you know, because I make my roll cages and stuff like that with using this wire, and it's one way I love using the wire. You know, I just started using it one day. I've made a tow truck pieces out of it. I've made all kinds of things out of it, and I really like it, and I really, you know, it gives it that custom look in a way. But you know, I'll use it in more further builds. You know, I'm gonna get more, just certain wire, and making it that way. You know, I got the tow truck build off that's not due until the beginning of June. I got a bunch of them coming up, but they're a long way out. You know, and I know with everything else that's been going on lately, I just kind of wanted it further out. You know, I got a that's not until the 1st of June, the tow truck build off that me and Cole from Kudos Diecast Customs are doing. You know, he's a great builder. You guys gotta check out his stuff. You know, we got Chris's Junkyard Designs, you gotta check his out. Jay's Diecast Creations, same deal. You know, there's so many great builders out there. And, you know, there are a lot of great people, and honestly, I'm just proud to say that, you know, they're my friends. You know, they understand, you know, the hobby I'm doing, and I think want to thank them very much for, you know, just kind of hanging in there with me, you know. And you see here about the back I'm telling you about, you know, they really, it really sets the theme off what I'm trying to do for this. And, you know, what I got going on is, like, I trimmed the base up a little bit. Traced the, I ended up making it into a drag strip. You know, I took this wing off of this dragster car that I had just sitting around. I was gonna originally just make my own dragster wing, but I was like, eh. It's like, you know, I know I got a dragster wing sitting around somewhere, so I decided to use the one that I had and just cut it up, modify it a little bit, and just go from there. You know, because I cut off all the end pieces to it. I was gonna just use it as is, but I ended up making my own little stand piece for it. And honestly, it turned out a lot better doing it this way than it did the other way. I got my one of my subscribers, Bill Davis. You know, he's still, I guess, new to this hobby. So, you know, I've been trying to give him some pointers on some stuff, you know. And I'm hoping, you know, everything's going well on that portion. You know, I don't know everything about the hobby, but the only way I see it is I'm always learning, just like everybody, you know. Like, honestly, some of the stuff I do, I know people don't do it the same way. Most people, like, got, like, little crimpers or something to make their own axles shorter this way, or use the axles that they got or something. But me, I like making full-blown axles. I don't really like using the stock axles, like the ones that are already together and stuff. I don't really like using those. But sometimes I'll use them, sometimes I won't. Like, one of the builds I got, I used the stock axles for. And it was alright. I didn't have any problems with it. You know, parachute that I got from Mitchell Toys a while back, you know, to add to this, because, you know, I wanted to make cool. Now, the colors I went with, as you see here, is a pearl-like purple, and I'm not a big purple person, but, you know, honestly, I think it looked really good, and yeah, it had purple on it to begin with. Yes, I know, but not this color purple, and I went a little different with it, you know. While I'm painting, you know, I'm hand painting this portion of it black. I'm not painting the whole thing. I didn't put decals on it either. You know, there's some builds I just don't like putting decals on it. But, excuse me. I didn't put no decals on it. You know, some of the parts I already had painted, I should say, like the base, the interior, you know, I already painted before I did this, you know, because I wanted to get it knocked down. Just so, like, the video wasn't too long, you know, I went ahead and sometimes I already paint things, you know, I don't show everything anymore. I used to show when I would paint, and what I did here was, you know, I painted it a pearl orange, so the colors are purple, orange, and black on this car. And, you know, I taped it off, didn't show the full taping. I just showed kind of what I was going with and what I was going for style-wise on this casting. You know, I wanted it to look cool, and it does. I love it. Here's what we started off with. You know, basic, you know, 1940s Woody. And I like the Woodies, don't get me wrong. But I don't know if you call it a truck, sedan, SUV, whatever it's called. And you see it's already purple, and I pretty much kind of went the same direction path with the purple color. But, yeah, I think my design's a little bit better. So, without further ado, let's check out the final results. And I'll see you next time at the range.